Mrs. Roden here, coming from my garden to wish you a happy Earth Day. I love Earth Day, and I am so sad that I do not get to be in the classroom with you for Earth Day. It's one of my favorite things to do. I have a lot of fun activities that we would be doing. So I wanted to bring one of them home to you guys by reading you a book called Magic Trash. I always read this one on Earth Day. And then I'm going to show you a little project. I'm going to take you on a little virtual field trip. And yeah, it's going to be awesome. So happy Earth Day. Earth Day has now been celebrated in the United States for 50 years. This is the 50th year it's been celebrated in the United States. It's a really big deal. I love it so much because it's a day where you take care of the planet. You clean up trash, you recycle, you learn about conservation, reusing things, all of that stuff. And so this book actually shows us how to reuse trash. And it teaches us about an artist, a real artist. His name is Tyree Guyton. And so let's go read the book, Magic Trash.
Magic Trash, a story of Tyree Guyton and his art. Written by J.H. Shapiro, illustrated by Vanessa Brantley Newton. Magic Trash. So this is a story of a real person. It is a true story that really happened, and I'm excited to read it to you. A winter chill whooshed down Heidelberg Street. Young Tyree Guyton buttoned his coat. Pop! His last button flipped into the gutter. He dove after it. Then dug through frosty leaves. He pried a popsicle stick from the ice. He hoisted a bicycle wheel off the curb. He scooped up a baseball cap buried in the snow. Pockets clanking, Tyree darted home, a home on the east side of Detroit that already bulged with 10 children. Shop around, Tyree sang along with the radio as he unloaded the day's finds. His mama didn't earn enough money sewing and cleaning to buy new shoes, much less bikes and balls, so he zapped fun into amazing junk that others tossed away. Popsicle sticks became boards to build a house. The cap soared like a rocket ship. The wheel bounced, spokes jumping, dots danced, let rockets fly, boards tower high, bounce, jump, and dance, magic trash. Tyree barely heard the thump thwack of his brother's games while he dreamed up designs. In school, he sat alone drawing pictures. When his report card arrived, his aunt asked, "Is Tyree dumb? Maybe crazy?" his mama whispered. Then, one sunny day when Tyree was 9, his Grandpa Sam, a house painter, plopped a brush into his hands. "Paint the world," Grandpa said. Tyree dipped into Grandpa's cans of color, slashing purple, slapping yellow, aiming his brush like a magic wand. Abracadabra! Tyree's shyness vanished. Sweet apples crunched when he glopped the red. He'd never seen Lake Huron, but it now splashed in a pool of blue. "Like new," Grandpa said of a glistening ladder. Tyree smiled and swirled a shade of green. Other kids on his street giggled and razzed. "Look at his green face! Ha! Green junk!" Still, as Tyree zoomed from bent bottle caps to rusty wheels, Grandpa Sam's words twirled in his head. "I'm going to be an artist," Tyree said. Mama hung her head. "That's not a job." He peered into Grandpa's twinkling eyes. Tyree clenched his brush. He would be an artist. Yes. Brush greens and blues on wheels and shoes. Slosh, slap, and splash. Magic trash. At age 12, Tyree squinted into spiraling smoke as National Guard tanks rolled down nearby Mount Elliott Street. All his life, neighbors had raced out of town to live in new suburbs. Some who had stayed exploded in rage like shaken bottles of Werner's ginger ale. Tyree gawked, teeth chattering. Rioters were burning buildings in his neighborhood. When he grew to be 16, Tyree, too, left the shapes and hues of Heidelberg Street to seek a new life. He marched as a soldier. He inspected cars in a factory. He doused fires as a firefighter. But he never forgot about painting his world, so he enrolled in art school to learn more about colors, lines, and designs. At last, Tyree bolted back home to Heidelberg. When he returned, though, his street had changed. Houses sat deserted, creeping with spirits of owners who had run away from the neighborhood. Tyree tripped over trash, lots of trash, and troublemakers lurked. They snuck into hollow houses. They even set fire to one. Woo, spirits swirl, new trouble swirl, kick, burn, and hurl, magic trash. No, cried Tyree, not on this street. His mama still lived in the same home. Grandpa Sam painted pictures. Inside now. Tyree grabbed his brush and burrowed through rubbish. He cast spells on suitcases and a slide trombone. Before the colors dried, Grandpa Sam hurried out to help. They painted a busted bus. They tied shoes to trees. They flung broken bikes and cast off tires on burned out buildings and forgotten yards. And they painted faces of God in blue, black, and orange. Their street sparkled. When trouble still sizzled in one discarded home, Tyree coated it in dots and squares of pink, blue, yellow, and purple, then perched a magenta watchdog on the porch. Dopey-dealing thieves hustled from its view, chased away by bright paint and barking trash. Tyree named one home Dotty Waddy and another Fun House. Spying hungry, crying children, he dangled broken baby dolls on telephone poles and rooftops. Dolls sobbed with each puff of wind. Maybe now others would see. Bright colors flash, scare dealers dash, bark, cry, and swing, magic trash. Some people squawked about garbage. A few neighbors complained to the city. The mayor and his helpers stomped. Soon, bulldozers roared up to the project to crush every doll and board. "You can't do that," yelled neighbors as dust swooped through the treetops. "Get out of here," others screamed. "Tyree's trash is beautiful." Tyree scrambled to snatch a few pieces. "This is my art," he cried. But the dots and stripes and baby dolls lay bashed and smashed and still. Tyree rubbed his eyes. Grandpa Sam poked at piles. Old houses talk. Some neighbors squawk. Crash, bash, and smash. Magic trash. Art had filled Tyree's and Grandpa Sam's lives. Now 93, Grandpa Sam had grown too old to help. "Never stop painting," Grandpa said, squeezing Tyree's hand. And then Tyree stood alone with brushes, paint, and trash. He wasn't alone for long, though. "We can help," neighbors called. "Your colors and dots chased away those thieves." Together they shoveled, swept, and hauled in new trash. Then, after 8 years of painting and rebuilding, neighbors heard wreckers screech a second time. Faces of God watched while the city crushed two more houses. "No," Tyree yelled. Tyree and his neighbors were hopping mad. "The street is ours," they said. "We'll never quit." They marched downtown to tell their story to a judge and jury. The city argued that Heidelberg Street was a garbage dump. "No," decided the court, "it is art. Tyree's work survived." The next day, Tyree and his neighbors began anew, aiming their brushes like magic wands. Children sang as they hammered and spattered designs. Even former troublemakers returned, ready to rake, sweep, and build. United by trash, they cast a spell on the street, brightening their home for good. Word of Heidelberg Street spread far. It blazed across the air. Folks from Canada, Kenya, and Japan scurried to the neighborhood. They stared. "Wow, look at that." Tyree waved his brush.
Welcome. And a warm breeze, dots danced, gleaming cast-offs jangled and jumped. Let rockets fly, boards tower high, bounce, jump, and dance, magic trash. Magic Trash is based on the life and art of painter and sculptor Tyree Guyton, born in 1955. In 2011, the Heidelberg Project celebrated its 25th anniversary. Tyree continues to work on Heidelberg Street and travels internationally to lecture and assist with installations of community art. He represented the United States in the 2008 Venice Architecture Biennale. You may visit the Heidelberg Project in Detroit or view Tyree Guyton's art in museums, including the Detroit Institute of Arts. Discover more about his work at www.heidelberg.org. All right, that is our story. It even gave us a bunch of good information about Tyree Guyton at the end of it. And now we are going to take a virtual little field trip to Heidelberg Street to see some of the amazing work that he made using old trash and junk that he found around the neighborhood. Here we go.
All right. So we just finished reading Magic Trash, all about Tyree Guyton and his art. And I thought it would be really neat, since that book was all illustrations and drawings, to show you what his work looks like in real life, what his actual art looks like. So we're going to take a little virtual field trip online here to Detroit, Michigan, to check out Heidelberg Street. But before we do that, we need to know, where is Detroit? That's a great question. Let me show you. So this is the United States of America. This is where we live. This is our country. We live in the state of Texas right here. Austin is our capital. And Hutto, where we go to school, is like right about here-ish, give or take, where that little red dot is. Michigan is way up here. It looks like it's in two pieces, but that's because this is water right here and it goes through it. It's part of the Great Lakes. But even though it's in two pieces, it is all Michigan. Detroit is a little city that's right here, right about where this red dot is. So now we know where Detroit is, so that we can take a little virtual trip there. Here is the artist, Tyree Guyton. Here he is on Heidelberg Street and painting one of the buses. This video that I've linked here, I can't really show it through this screencast that I'm doing right now, but I will share it with you so that if you want to watch it, it's really neat. It's a little interview with our artist, Tyree Guyton, about his project, and it's really fun to watch. So I'll share that with you later. All right, and here are some photos. I hope you are inspired by the Heidelberg Project. And those are the pictures. I hope you enjoyed looking through them and got some great ideas of how you can make amazing art out of trash and things that are left behind. I think it's a really neat way to reduce, reuse, and even recycle a little bit this Earth Day. And it's a great way to make something that's beautiful and colorful. So I hope you enjoyed our little quick field trip to Detroit, Michigan. And now I am going to show you a neat project that we're going to make that takes trash and turns it into something beautiful just like our artist, Tyree Guyton.
Hey, first grade, Mrs. Roden here. I'm back in my office. I hope you enjoyed reading Magic Trash. I also hope you enjoyed learning more about the artist and about Heidelberg Street and where he did his art. I hope you had fun with it. So now we learned that he has turned and is still turning trash into wonderful, amazing, colorful art. So we're going to do something for Earth Day. We're going to reuse something that we would think of as trash, and we're going to make some art out of it. So basically all you need is a plastic water bottle that you would recycle. All I have are these little ones at my house. I don't really keep a lot of them here, but I have this little one and that'll work. You're going to need some scissors. Got my scissors. And you're going to need some colorful Sharpies. I don't have a lot of colorful Sharpies here at my house. They're all in my classroom, which I'm kind of sad about. But I have black and I have green, so we'll make it work. First, I'm going to show you what it looks like. I took a picture last year. My class did this last year at my other school. So I'll show you a picture of it right here. Basically, all of the water bottles get turned into beautiful art that you can hang from a tree outside, that you can hang up in your house to make it more beautiful, in your neighborhood, your garden, your community. You can put it somewhere and make a little beauty for our world. So yeah, there's some ideas of what they can look like. And now I'm going to take my bottle. I'm going to take off this little label first. I'm going to use the scissors because this could take a while. All right, there we go. Label off. I'm going to take the lid off. We don't need the lid. You can recycle it. You can get rid of it. And then this is something you'll need help with an adult. You will cut off, very carefully, the bottom of the bottle. So definitely you want an adult or someone who's really good with scissors to help you out with it. So let me do that real quick, and then I'll show you what it looks like. All right, I'm back. I have cut the bottom off of my bottle. I can recycle this. I can get rid of that. And now I have an empty water bottle with no bottom, no lid, and I'm going to color it. So I'm going to take my Sharpies. Hopefully you guys have some colorful ones. If not, you can always make a really cute face at your parents and ask them for some. They can order you some on Amazon. Or just use what you have. See if there's any paint or anything that'll work. Sharpie works great because it keeps. So I'm going to start coloring this. And I'm going to make it mostly green. I might put a little pattern of black in there. And the trick to this is you want to cover it up as best you can. You want to put a lot of color on there. You don't want a lot of clear showing through, because that way it'll look really nice when you're all done with it. So I'm going to, here's how I've started. I have a lot more to go. Instead of you just watching me color this for a few minutes, I'm going to stop my video and I'll show you what to do afterwards. All right, I'm back. I have colored my water bottle. Even though I just had green and black, I think it looks kind of fun. I made a little pattern, black and green stripes on there. So now I'm going to cut it. You might need some help with this unless you're really good with scissors. I would definitely ask for some help. We're going to spiral cut it. So I'm going to start at one end on the bottom, and I'm just going to kind of start cutting. And I want it to be in one big piece. I don't want to cut any pieces off. So my scissors are kind of angled up at a diagonal, and I'm just going to cut. You stop up at the top, and here it is, woohoo! A beautiful water bottle that is now a piece of art. So let's go and take it outside, and I'll hang it up so I can think about you guys always. Here we go. All right, here we are outside in my yard again. My garden's that way. Behind me is Peach Tree. We've got a lot of little peaches growing on it right now. They're not ready to eat yet, but they will be soon. And I've got my art that we have taken an old piece of trash and turned it into something beautiful. So now I'm going to take it. We've got the little loop right here. And I'm just going to put it this stick some leaves through it. I'm going to do it very carefully. And then, there it is, a beautiful piece of trash. We took it, we reused it, and we made it something beautiful. And now it'll be hanging in my tree for me to look at and think of you guys. I love you, first grade. I hope you had an awesome time on our Earth Day field trip learning about reusing trash to make art. Bye, first grade.